Good morning, students. With today we will see about the breast complications in puerperium. The breast common breast complications are breast engorgement, crack and retractor nipple, mastitis and breast abscess, and lactation failure. Breast engorgement. Breast engorgement occurs in the mammary glands due to expansion and pressure exerted by the synthesis of milk. Engorgement is caused by a buildup of milk, blood, and other fluids in the breast tissues is in storage of breast milk. Breast engorgement is the painful overfilling of the breast with milk. This is usually caused by an imbalance between milk supply and infant demand. The causes include it caused due to exaggerated normal venous and lymphatic engorgement of the breast precedes lactation. This in turn prevents the escape of milk from the lacteal system. The primiparous patient with elastic breasts are likely to be developed. It's an indication that baby is not with the step with the stage of lactation. Usually it occurs by third and fourth day of postpartum. The symptoms include pain and feeling of tenderness or heaviness in both breasts, generalized malaise or even increase in temperature, painful breastfeeding. The prevention include avoid pre-lactial feeds, initiate breastfeeding in early, unrestricted, exclusive breastfeeding on demand, feeding in the correct position. Treatment includes support the breast with proper size braces, frequent suckling, manual expression of any remaining milk after each feed, analgesics for pain relief, frequent breastfeeding. In severe cases, gentle use of breast pump can be advised. Cracked and retracted nipple. Nipple become painful due to loss of surface epithelium with the formation of raw area on the nipple or due to fish associated either at the from the nipple. It is caused by unclean hygiene, resulting in formation of crust over the nipple, retracted nipple, and trauma from the baby's mouth due to incorrect attachment to the breast. The condition may be asymptomatic but becomes painful when the infant sucks. When infected, the infection may spread to deeper tissue, producing mastitis. Prophylaxis include local cleanliness during pregnancy and in puerperium before and after each breastfeeding to prevent crust formation over the nipple. Treatment, correct attachment will provide immediate relief from the pain and rapid healing. Fresh human milk and saliva has got healing process. Purified lanolin with the mother's milk is applied 3 to 4 times to hasten the healing. Acute mastitis, the mode of infection is by two different types of mastitis depending upon the site of infection. The first one is infection that involves the breast parenchymal tissue leading to cellulitis. Second, infection gains access to the lactulophorous duct leading to development of primary mammary adenitis. Onset, the superficial cellulitis, acute onset during the first two to four weeks of postpartum. Clinical features include symptoms include generalized malaise, headache, nausea, vomiting, fever over 102 degrees Celsius with the chills, severe pain, tender swelling in one quadrant of the breast. Signs include presence of toxic features, presence of swelling on the breast, the overlying skin is red, hot and flushed, and heals the tense and tender. Diagnosis. The macroscopic examination of breast shows leukocytes more than 10^6 mL and bacterial count is more than 10^3 mL supports diagnosis of mastitis. Complications of acute mastitis is breast abscess. Prophylaxis, thorough washing before each feed, cleaning the nipple before and after feed, keeping them dry, reduce the nosocomial infection rate. Management by breast support, plenty of fluids. Breastfeeding is continued with good attachment. Infected side is emptied manually with each feed, antibiotics and analgesics. Next is breast abscess. The features are flushed breast or not responding to antibiotics, edema, marked tenderness, swinging temperature. If abscess found, it is to be trained under GA by deep radial incision extending from near areolar margin to prevent injury to the lactiferous ducts. The cavity is packed with gauze, which should be replaced after 24 hours by smaller pack. The procedure continued till it heals. Breastfeeding can be continued from the unaffected side. Infected breast is mechanically pumped every 2 hours. Lactation failure. Inadequate milk production is known as lactation failure. The causes are infrequent sucking, depression or anxiety in the state of puerperium, reluctance of apprehension to nursing, ill developments of nipples, painful breast lesion, endogenous suppression of prolactin, prolactin inhibitions by ergot preparation or diuretics. Treatment innately. Counsel the mother regarding breastfeeding and its advantage. Treat any retracted nipple. Puerperium, encourage fluid intake. Feed the baby regularly. Treat painful breast lesions and galactagogues can be administered. thromboembolic disorders or piperium that we will see later. Thank you.